Today, warm to remembrances of holidays past as YTV Movies presents the Father Knows Best Christmas Reunion.
She remembered when she was 3 years old. I held her up so she could see the tree, and she reached out and touched it.
You know, sorting through the ornaments is a little bit like going through the family album. All our Christmases with the children.
Bud's horn. It's the first thing you put on the tree.
Oh, and remember how Kathy loved this. She had a special name for it. What was it now? Bueller?
Yeah. that brings back a Christmas. Do you remember when my sister Neva visited us?
And that awful run-in she had with Kathy.
We thought we were headed for disaster that Christmas Eve.
Well, it won't be long now. Pretty soon we'll get a glimpse of old Santa's boot coming down the chimney.
Does she'll give him a hot foot. Come on, Cap, snap out of it. What are you trying to do, veto Christmas? Boy, some Christmas. We're a little grumpy down here, and... You know, Mom's still upstairs trying to talk Aunt Eva into coming down and join us. Why'd she make the trip here?
Shh!
Well, this is very festive and Christmassy. Doesn't the tree look pretty?
Yes, lovely.
Come in and join our merry band, and we'll make the welkin ring. Anybody here ever rung a welkin before? Neva, my favorite sister, may I serve you from the traditional Anderson wassail bowl? Oh, I ran across a recipe the other day that tells how they used to make the wassail bowl. Sounded horrible. They used to put sugar and nutmeg and a lot of stuff into ale and wine. And they heated the whole mess. Had cooked apples floating in it. I can just see Countess So-and-so daintily lifting her cup and getting slapped in the puss with a soggy apple. here's to a very Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Well, let's not let our enthusiasm get out of control. Maybe we need a good rousing song. Or, let's sneak a look at our presents. How about opening a few? What do you say, kitten? I hope you get something I can play with. Oh, here's one for Kathy. Oh, no, I'm wrong. It's from Kathy, and it's for... Aunt Neva. Well, deliver your present to Aunt Neva, Kathy.
Late this year letting us know their Christmas plan.
Well, maybe they'll all be busy and nobody will come.
Oh, fat chance. The way they roared in here for our anniversary. We're sound of ho-ho-ho and jingle bell. They come busting down the door.
Thea, will you take down the big box?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, what have you got in there?
Bricks? No. Not even the light.
Just for a minute. There's something I want to ask you and Jim.
All right, what is it?
Maybe Jim told you. George and Jan Newman next door are selling their house.
Yeah. Oh, yes, yeah. I knew they were planning to.
You didn't lose any time getting a prospect.
Well, those people I showed the house to, they're lukewarm about it. But they like the looks of yours. Now, I know this is sudden and right out of the blue, but Jim, have you and Margaret ever thought of selling? I know the children are all grown and out on their own. Maybe you don't need this much house.
Oh, to tell you the truth, we've never given it a thought.
Well, it's been home for so many years. Why, I couldn't imagine living anywhere else.
Believe me, I understand, but I had to ask. Huh? If you should change your mind, I can sell it like that.
Well, I'll tell you what, Louise, if we ever do change our mind, you'll be the very first person that we'll let know.
Oh, thank you, Jim.
There you are. Bye. That is a wild idea.
Oh, what will they do? Become a couple of gypsies?
Oh, we can buy a motorhome, head for the hills.
The children would have a fit.
Well, it might be quite an adventure.
No matter where they are, this is still home.
Yeah.
Where are we going?
See if I can find the outside Christmas lights.
They're in the garage on the second shelf, in the box marked dishes. Hello? Yes. Yes, our place. Thank you. Well, that phone call was from Betty.
Did you tell her it was about time?
Well, she's been waiting to hear from Frank. It doesn't look as though she and the girls will be here for Christmas.
Why not?
Well, it all comes from having a fiancé who was an airline pilot. Frank's been transferred to the overseas run, Rome, London, and he wants Betty and the girls to go with him and spend Christmas in London.
Well, you can't expect them to give that up.
Oh, I'm kind of looking forward to having them for a few days.
Yeah.
The girls are growing so fast. You found the light.
Oh, yeah. In the right box, too. Oh. Yes, this is Jim Anderson. Yeah. Yeah, I'll wait.
Margaret!
Hi!
I need a place to hide. Come on in. I couldn't stay over at our house. The suspense, waiting for the phone to ring.
Well, what's happening?
Well, we listed our house for sale with Louise Baker just this morning. This afternoon, a couple came through, and they're in her office right now deciding. I'm so excited, I haven't even shopped for dinner.
Oh, well, come on in the house. I'm sure I've got something in the freezer to tide you over.
No, Jenny, we haven't heard from him. Oh, as a matter, yes. Well, a couple of weeks ago, we got a postcard, you know, from Glen Falls. He didn't say anything about wanting to be home or anything about Christmas.
Well, how about a couple of ham steaks?
Oh, perfect. I'll pay back tomorrow.
Yeah?
I am so keyed up. Because if this deal goes through, George and I are giving each other a Christmas present. A cruise to South America. And then we're going to live in Florida.
Well, how fantastic.
Well, I knew Bud never cared very much about living in a big city, but I didn't know you were seriously planning a move.
I'm ready to go, Margaret.
Yeah?
We've loved living next door to you and Jim. And we're going to miss you.
I'll tell you what,
Louise, take care of all. She closed the deal.
That's like phoning from the middle of a basketball game.
What'd she say?
Well, Bud's off somewhere looking for a place to move his business, and I guess Christmas is the last thing on their mind.
Well, that leaves Kathy.
Yeah.
At least she's never let us down. Why don't you put in a call to her and I'll start the dinner.
Okay. Hi, honey.
Hi.
How are you? Wonderful. Say, we were putting our plans together for Christmas. We were just wondering if... Oh. Oh, yeah. Well, that sounds like a lot of fun. Yeah. Oh, you must have twisted his arm. Well, you'll have a good time up there. That's beautiful country. Yeah, well, we'll miss you, of course, honey, but I'll tell you what. You call us Christmas Eve, and we'll sing Deck the Halls over long distance. Huh? Okay, darling. God bless. Goodbye, dear.
Not coming.
She and Dr. Jason had an invitation to go skiing up at Elk Mountain. But they'll be here for New Year's.
I suppose it had to happen sometime. Our first Christmas without the children.
Where? Why? Sweatshirts. Baseball caps. T-shirts. Fun gear for the cool kid in your unit. Wear why and get noticed. Perfect for holiday gift giving. Order yours by calling this toll-free number today. 1-800-665-9881. Charge it to your Visa, MasterCard, or American Express. Money orders accepted too. Wear why and make a scene.
Time and time again, one battery has risen above the rest. When the dust has settled, it's always been the one left standing. Today's Duracell is the longest lasting ever, which makes it the longest lasting Duracell
Gila.
You can buy. Case closed.
Introducing Pillsbury Pie Crust. Homemade flaky pie crust and nothing flat.
Big news at the Huggies Lab. What a breakthrough. Totally rethought, refined, redesigned. New Huggies Ultra Trim Diapers. A smart way to help stop leaks. They're nearly 50% thinner than ordinary diapers for a trimmer, pant-like fit. And now reprogrammed with unique curved leg elastics. Plus revolutionary materials absorb better than ever to help stop leaks. New Huggies. Huggies Ultra Trim, totally redesigned to create big smiles.
Don't like that,
no.
Huh?
Oh, I love him.
You would. Oh. Probably more expensive than that thing over there.
No, it is.
You know, I think we just established a new world record.
What kind?
The longest distance two people ever walked in one department store in one night.
Well, if the children aren't coming home for Christmas, we've got to get these gifts in the mail.
I know.
Toys are getting more wonderful every year.
Yeah.
Oh, Jim,
yeah.
Look.
Oh. Anybody home?
Oh, look at all the suits and dresses in the wardrobe. Yeah. Oh, and those darling little slippers by the bed. Wouldn't Jenny just love it?
You're a natural-born spoiler, granddaughter.
Oh, may I help you?
We're just admiring the doll, Al.
Well, you're Mr. and Mrs. Anderson, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Kathy Ferris.
Yes.
Yes, and you're a friend of Kathy's, and I wish I could remember your name.
Marilyn Murphy. Kathy and I were together on the swimming team in high school. Listen, how's Kathy?
Oh, she's teaching in Kansas City. You know, swimming, skiing, all kinds of sports like that.
She married? Almost. I know all your kids always come home for Christmas. Give them my best.
Yes,
yes, you will.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Well, it's a little hard to tell people your children aren't coming home for Christmas. Oh, Jim, look.
Have you been drinking your milk and eating your vegetables and being a real good girl? Then I'll come by and see you Christmas Eve, okay?
Oh, the time we brought ours to see Santa. You know, I think it's the same guy.
I was looking forward to bringing Robbie and Jenny and Ellen.
Yeah. Well, maybe next year.
I don't think so.
What?
Well, next year, Bud and Betty and Kathy will be farther away and deeper into their own lives.
Well, we can't change that. Nothing stays the same. You know that, honey.
I know. Jim, let's sell the house.
Sell a house? You mean that?
Well, what do we need it for? We bought it in the first place because we were having the children. They're gone, and, well, there's no need for it.
Well, let's talk about it another time. Come on, let's go by the dollhouse for the girls.
Well, Merry Christmas again, folks.
Pretty quiet all the way home.
Mm-hmm.
I almost wish this weren't Christmas.
You want to skip it? We can, you know. All we have to do is mail the presents and forget the whole thing.
The hard part is understanding that the children really don't care anymore.
Oh, they showed up for our anniversary.
Oh, after you called and asked them to come.
Honey, let's think a while about selling the house. There's so much here, all of our lives with the children.
But that was a time, and that time is gone. We'll sell the house and begin a new time. Oh, I'll cry a little, but that'll be the end of it.
I have to tell you, Jim, I was surprised when you called. I really didn't think when it came right down to it that you and Margaret would sell.
Well, I was kind of surprised myself. We decided suddenly last night.
The hot water heater blew up?
No, we were in the toy department watching Santa Claus.
The agreement to sell.
Oh.
You can check the terms. I think it's all there as you gave it to me on the phone.
Hmm.
I hope you're ready to move. It's going to sell fast.
Yeah.
You and Margaret have any plans, what you'll do?
No, I think we'll just try to get through Christmas first.
Such a busy time with the children and the grandchildren.
Well, it's a little different this year. They all have other plans.
They do scatter, don't they?
Like leaves in the wind.
I'll call Margaret and set a time to go through the house. I've never seen all of it.
Well, you won't have any problems. It's not very crowded.
Jim, I know how you and Margaret must feel. I'll try to make it all as painless as possible.
I know, Louise. Thank you. You're very sweet. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. We made some pictures of that house. I love the view from this kitchen window.
Well, it's especially pretty in the spring when the lilacs come into bloom. Well, we remodeled this kitchen about 2 years ago.
Oh, I hated to lose that old wooden drain board. It reminded me of Grandfather's kitchen. I must say, your kitchen looks brand new.
Well, the children weren't raised in this one. But there are a few battle scars.
Are those marks what I think they are?
Yeah. That's where we measured how much the children grew each year. Well, it'll all be painted over.
You know, some people whose house I sold last month had the same thing. They took the whole piece of wood out and took it with them.
Oh, well, I'm afraid if we took all our memories with us, we'd have to tear down the whole house.
Oh, I'm sorry. The children aren't coming for Christmas. Jim said Betty and the girls would be in London.
Well, the airline pilot Betty met when she was in high school is very important in her life again. They're engaged.
Lovely.
We don't have air conditioning, but the house is insulated, and, the furnace was new, 5 years ago.
Excuse me. I'll just mosey around.
Hello?
Margaret, I'm home! Margaret!
She's on the
phone. Oh, I'm sorry, Louise. I didn't know you were here.
Margaret and I are just finishing up with the facts and figures. It's a good house.
Yeah, it's kept us warm and snug for a good many years.
Jim, Betty just phoned.
Yeah?
Frank's bringing the girls down on his 120 flight.
Isn't Betty coming?
Well, she has a meeting in Milwaukee, but she'll be alone later.
Whatever happened in London?
Oh, I don't know. There was so much noise in that connection, I could only hear half of what she said.
Oh, I'm sorry, Louise. We're having a little trouble keeping track of our offspring.
Well, we're finished anyway.
Oh.
I'll put on my parka and disappear into the Arctic afternoon. Thank you, Margaret.
Yes.
Well,
thanks a lot for coming over.
Okay,
over here.
Goodbye, dear.
Goodbye. Oh, what do you know? I had a feeling that as sure as we put this house on the market, at least one of the children would have a change of heart.
Oh, I don't think there'll be any action before Christmas. No one buys a house during the holidays.
Hey, and another thing. What's this we hear about Captain Carlton going to fly the Atlantic?
It's all true. First run tomorrow.
You make it and we'll give you a ticker tape parade.
So... can you get me a rental car, Julie? I need it for a couple of hours. I'm going to be taking flight 34 back to Chicago tonight.
You want a Rose or Bentley?
That surprised me.
Oh,
Captain Frank!
What?
We're going from the bathroom.
I told you it was right around the corner.
I want to find the two guys with pictures on.
That's right. One has a picture of a lady and one has a picture of a man.
Ellen thought the man was a lady in a pantsuit.
And you finally found it?
Finally!
Oh, good. Now, come on, let's get going. Dad and Grandpa are waiting for you.
You got your car.
Oh, nice. Thank you. See you later.
Here come the Chicago Bears. How are you, darling? I assume Betty will be along later.
Well, there was no reason for the girls to stay around in Chicago while Betty was in Milwaukee.
Yeah.
She figured you wouldn't suffer too much if you had them for a few days.
You can imagine how much we'll suffer.
Come on.
Warm yourself by the fire.
Well, that's what I need.
Hey, what was all that stuff about Christmas in London? The girls didn't want to go.
People love London.
Come on, open the coat. This is all there with the plan.
Smiling face. It's a gift, an embrace. It's nuts fire roasted and coconut toasted. It's butter and milk. It's chocolate like silk. It's your feelings best told when you give pot of gold. The gift that's wrapped in a rainbow.
You know, I can spend hours in my studio, drawing, shaping my ideas. It's my time, daydreaming, and the hours just drift away. That's when I reach for a Mars Dark.
Rich, dark chocolate over creamy vanilla nougat and buttery caramel.
It's a special part of my day.
Mars for a day, work, rest, and play.
Where, why? Sweatshirts, baseball caps, t-shirts, fun gear for the cool kid in your unit. Where, why, and get noticed. Perfect for holiday gift giving. Order yours by calling this toll-free number today, 1-800-665-9881. Charge it to your Visa, MasterCard, or American Express. Money orders accepted too. Where, why, and make a scene.
Yesterday,
ha!
The kids called him Dad.
What's up?
Today, they call him
Mrs. Doubtfire.
Mrs. Doubtfire.
Mrs. Doubtfire.
I'm a hip old granny who could hip-hop, bebop, dance, see, and drop, and yo-yo make a wicked cup of coo-coo.
Robin Williams is Mrs. Doubtfire. Now playing at theaters everywhere.
Your mother and Aunt Kathy. Oh, go on. You know what
you
said.
You remember?
Don't get the traveling cases.
Oh, sit down, Fred. There's something. Well, now we have them settled. What about you and Betty?
Well, let's see. I arrive in Chicago from Rome at 11 a.m. the day before Christmas. Mm-hmm. Betty meets me at the airport. I catch the 12:20 flight to Springfield, and we're here at Christmas Eve.
That's going to take some careful timing.
Well, I was told by your lovely daughter, Betty, if I want to marry her and be the father to those kids, I have to be around on all the holidays, no matter what, and I promise.
I think you'll be safe with dinner tonight.
Oh, no, Margaret, I'm sorry. I got to be back in 40 minutes.
Oh.
Let me say goodbye to the kids.
Here you go. Girls! Girls, come on down and say goodbye to your almost father.
Good luck on all your travels.
Thanks.
We'll meet you at the airport on Christmas Eve.
Okay, I'll be there.
Hey!
Oh.
I'll see you Christmas.
Okay.
Take care of yourself.
Well, have a nice day, girl.
All right, behave.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Well, girls, how about some cocoa and cookies in the kitchen?
And marshmallows.
Girl, just one more and we'll be finished.
Yay!
How about that?
Yay.
Now, you kids better get inside before you freeze.
We're cold, Grandpa.
Oh, not much enough. How does that look?
I think you got too many green ones together.
Well, you know what that is. These are made in Ireland, and they love green over there.
That too. No, he just made that up.
Well, I was wondering when you'd get around to putting up the rest of your lights. Yeah, I don't want any trouble with you, George. Girls, you know Mr. Newman from next door?
Yeah. Hi.
How's he doing, ladies?
I think you've got too many green ones together.
Well, how's the sale of your house going, Jim?
What house, Grandpa?
Say, Jim, you hear the weather on the news?
We haven't had the TV on. What's happening?
They say we're in for a blizzard.
Yay! Snow for Christmas!
Yeah, it's building up in Canada. In the next 3 or 4 days, it's supposed to come howling through here, warnings to farmers, cautioning against travel, the whole thing.
Well, you better oil up your snow shovel, George.
Stay with what house, Grandpa?
Well, I'm going to go inside where it's warm. But you take care of your grandpa, girls.
We will.
Well, I guess that's it. How about it?
The question now is, will they light up?
Oh, honey, turn on the outside light, will you?
Yay!
Yay!
Okay?
All right!
Grandpa?
Yeah?
Was Mr. Newman talking about when he said the sale of your house?
Well, that's
sometime in the future, honey. We'll talk about it later.
Come on, get in there. Hurry up. Peace.
You girls remember last year we had the tree by the window.
I like it better by the fireplace. Like to see on Christmas cards.
Well, that's good point.
But by the front window in the daytime, you can see right through it.
That's good too.
Yes. Well, I think I like the fireplace too.
Well, let's take a vote.
Yeah. I vote for the fireplace.
All those in favor of the fireplace.
Well,
wonderful. We couldn't be happier. Well, of course we'll wait up for you. You drive carefully now. Bye.
Bud and Jean and Robbie are coming.
They're in Halesburg. Bud says they'll be here by midnight.
That's neat. Then everybody will be here.
You said it, dear. At the first sound of jingle bells.
But by the time they get here, you'll be visiting with the sugar plum fairies.
Oh,
it's a long way, and it'll be late. You have no idea. It'll be after midnight.
Well, sweet.
Maybe 1 o'clock. Some...
Well, do you think something happened?
Oh, honey, you know Bud. He calculates his time of arrival based upon 125 miles an hour. Then goes 55. There they are.
I'll get the zombie. Come on, let me go, kid.
Gotcha.
This way.
Speed.
You think you can handle him?
Oh,
do you want some help with your stuff?
No, Mom.
We got a system.
Did we take it off the same way we put it on, only backwards?
Oh, God. Oh, don't pick him up, Jim. Keep him off.
2 degrees to starboard, skipper, and steady as you go.
Don't wake up, Robbie. I just got to
get you. Can you believe how he's grown?
Oh, I'm so tired.
Put it in second gear, Robbie, and you'll make it fine. That's it.
Jim, put away your stuff. I'll make some hot cocoa. Oh, wonderful.
Here we go. Bloopity-doo.
Really a shame Kathy can't make it.
Yeah.
What a laugh, though. I heard dragging poor old Jason out, making him go skiing.
How about that?
I know that's the last thing in the world a guy wants to do.
Well, if he wants to keep up with Kathy, he's better get used to it.
Betty and her airline captain still got together?
Oh, yeah. She almost had a nail in the post.
Oh, Jim.
I think the only thing standing in the way is the job.
Well, Betty's concerned that he's away from home too much to make a good father. He disagrees.
Get a load of this. He gets through with a round trip to Rome at 11:30 a.m. the day before Christmas. Betty flies from Milwaukee to Chicago. They join and take the 12:20 to Springfield.
Oh, boy.
How about that?
He's going to be out of it.
The way the weather's been going, the Chicago airport could be closed for Christmas. Well, I think Frank will get them here if he hasn't come by dog sled.
Well, how are things?
Oh, things are good.
Good.
Well, I mean, I still don't see him very often.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, I have been running around lately. I'm trying to find a new location for the bike shop.
Mm.
Jane's not happy living in the city, and I can't blame her, really.
I didn't say that. And I'm not crazy about living in an apartment in Minneapolis, but I'd be happy anywhere Bud could settle and be contented. Well, Jim and I have some news for you.
What?
Oh, well, your mother and I have decided to sell the house.
Oh, no.
Sell the house?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Well, we talked it over and we think we don't need this bigger house.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I've kind of wondered how long we're going to hang on to it, but...
Well, The time has come, the walrus said.
Oh, it's going to seem strange. Mm-hmm. We've always thought of you and Margaret and this house as being sort of the one thing that would just never change, that you'd always be here.
Well, it hasn't been an easy decision.
Anna, I should like coming to your house for Christmas.
Above the rest. When the dust is settled, it's always been the one left standing. Today's Duracell is the longest lasting ever, which makes it the longest lasting Duracell you can buy. Case closed.
I like my Jillian to look dressed up, even when she's not dressed up.
Dr. Jennifer Mayer, pediatrician and mother.
But one thing I won't compromise on is dryness. That's why I like these new Pampers prints. They've got great looking patterns, and nothing keeps my Jillian drier here.
Compared to the next most popular diaper, Pampers for walkers help prevent leaks better.
When she's drier, she's happier.
Now all the dryness of Pampers also comes in the cutest new prints. For your little prince and princess.
Going out with Amy yet?
Yeah. So, man, I gotta stop breaking out by then.
You're not washing with Clearasil every day?
No, soap. Why?
Soap's fine for cars. We're talking about your face.
Look, without cleansing, acne pimples may form. But Clearasil Daily Face Wash fights bacteria, helping stop pimples before they start.
Wow, looking clean. But she missed a spot.
Where?
Right over here.
Clearasil. Get clear, stay clear.
This holiday season, Robin Williams is the man of the year.
Look at me right now, Money Penny. I want to undo that bow and get to know you.
And the woman of the year.
Surprise.
In the movie of the year. Mrs. Doubtfire. Now playing at theaters everywhere.
Degrees above zero, cold enough to freeze your nose.
When is it going to snow more?
Ask your mother and Fred Thompson to get here, I hope. Now get up to the table and I'll start breakfast.
I couldn't
wake
up.
Really,
Anna? Really?
Well, you should have slept in. You had a bad trip yesterday.
Yeah, I know. What's your breakfast?
Scrambled eggs. Tough, mean, or easy.
What kind are you having? I'll have mean. Then I'll have tough.
All right.
How can you bear to sell this house, Margaret?
Oh, I gotta tell you, it's not going to be easy. Now, I've never lived in a house, never in my life. Now, that's hard to imagine. I've always wanted a home where no one lives above or below. When you walk upstairs, it's still yours. A house just like this.
Let's get the Christmas tree now, Grandpa.
Breakfast first. Girls, look who's here.
Hi, Bobby.
Hi.
Well, they really fall over each other, don't they?
What am I supposed to do? Kiss them or something?
Yeah, you can try it sometimes.
Yeah, not me, not them.
Well, you sure know how to make a girl's heart sing.
Isn't that the difference?
Good morning.
Well, listen to your old father times.
Tweedledee and Tweedledum.
Eggs are ready.
When are we going to get the Christmas tree, Grandpa?
Everybody has breakfast. Children in here and grown-ups in the dining room.
How big is the tree going to be?
Oh, about 50 feet.
Oh, he's pulling your leg, Robbie.
You should know by now we have a really weird grandpa.
Nice, squeezed orange juice. Yeah, we're talking. Well, that brings back a lot of Sunday mornings in this room.
Oh, but we had it other times, too. Who could that be?
It sounds like Kathy.
Kathy? Not oh, very
Thank you very much.
Oh, come on.
What in the world happened to you?
You're not going to believe it. You're just really not going to believe it.
this man, dear.
Well, before she starts the replay, hello, Jean. Good to see you.
How you doing, Gibby?
Just in time for breakfast. Oh, thanks.
Come on,
guys. Come on.
Right.
Thank you.
Come on.
How you doing?
I'm tired.
Thank you.
Come on.
Thank you.
Come on.
Now, what is this, something that, none of us are going to believe?
Well, you know, we were invited up to the mountains to go skiing.
If I had any sense at all, I'd have said no right then and there. But you know, Kathy.
Yes, we've met.
Well, my brilliant friend here, he doesn't know a ski from third base, so we figured a little bit of practice wouldn't hurt.
I let her talk me into these things. I don't know why.
Because you can't chew gum and walk at the same time, darling. But you're a brilliant doctor, and I love you. Anyway, there's this department store about two stories. We'll have the indoor ski slope about two stories high with cornflakes or something for snow.
Yeah, well, it looked easy. Kids were going down.
Well, you know, he puts on his skis, starts down the slope, and fell right into the credit department. I don't believe it.
You're lucky it wasn't more serious.
Oh, no, I only break arms and ankles.
Oh, I see.
And he'll do anything to get out of going skiing. Anyway, here we are.
Oh, I'm sorry about your fall, but I can't tell you how happy we are that you're going to be here for Christmas. Well, Kathy doesn't believe it, but actually I planned it all this way.
Oh, I believe it. Well, now you're a real skier.
Sure, anyway.
I'm going to stop by Louise Baker's and ask her to hold off showing the house till after the kids have left. There's no sense in making them uncomfortable.
Oh, that's a good thought.
Anything you want from the market? A side of beef, 10 gallons of milk?
2 loaves of bread and a barrel of peanut butter.
Okay, darling.
Hey, what happened? I thought we were finished with all that.
Oh, go on. You love it.
Howling hyenas.
Oh, look at this one. Look at this one. Look at the tree.
You can stay on the lot now.
There's a view.
She's
a pretty one.
Be right with you, fellas. Gotta tie the trees up for a big blow.
Seems like every year around Christmas we get hit with a blizzard. Last year my trees was down flat under a foot of snow.
What is the forecast?
Forecast? What do people say day after tomorrow? Wish those Canadians would keep their blizzards to themselves. Be right back.
Yeah, that's okay.
Problems. Everybody's got their problems.
What are yours, son?
Thanks, Dad.
Well, it's Jean. She's just not happy. I don't know. Things were going good after we all got together for your anniversary. It's been kind of going downhill since then.
Are you away a lot?
Well, no. No, not that much anymore. I'm only racing locally now. I wish I knew what was bugging her.
Maybe she'd like to know what's bugging you.
Oh, I got a real neat tree. Real good. Come on, Dad.
Whoever heard of a tree with a cat?
A closing is in 60 days, Harry, and with the holidays coming, we lose a lot of time there. And you can't have the painters closing. Until
Louise,
the closing.
I'm sorry, I'm double parked out in front. I'm in a hurry.
Harry, I'll call you back.
Look, can you cool the sale of the house till after the holidays? The kids showed up after all, and you know it'd be awkward showing it with people going in and out. You understand.
Sure, but I can't do it, Jim.
Why not?
But I have a hot prospect coming in from out of town, and there's no way to reach it.
How far out of town?
Indianapolis.
Oh.
He and his family are making the trip just for the purpose.
Well, I guess that settles that. I'm being paid. Well... So long, dear. Thanks,
Jennifer. I'm sorry.
That's
Jim.
All right. Yeah.
Really, too bad.
Okay, goodbye.
I think selling this house will be the greatest thing you and Dad ever did.
Well, it's not the easiest.
You can move to Colorado. Get a place in Aspen. Jason and I could live up there to see you.
Poor Jason.
The way you treat him is the one he even speaks to you.
Mother.
He loves it. In Kansas City, he's known as the great Dr. Harper super surgeon, and everybody kowtows to him. And I call him a klutz. Do you love him?
Yeah, Mom, I do. He's a great guy.
Well, that's a good start.
Hey!
they're going to get a smaller tree, and every year it gets bigger.
Get that in, Bobby. We'll stick away.
Hey, it's a beautiful tree.
Oh,
listen, everybody, I'll see you later tonight.
What, are you going to go hit the slopes?
I'm going to hobble down to the nearest motel and get some sleep.
Oh, you know, he's only been up 24 hours. He's tired.
You're not going to any motel. We'll put you up on a couch in the den.
Of course.
You know,
I won't give you an argument.
Yeah, it's really great, because I told him that earlier.
See, there is room for one more in the house.
Listen, when is Biddy and Frank going to get here?
Didn't you say the day after tomorrow, huh? Christmas Eve?
Yeah. Betty's flying into Chicago from Milwaukee. Frank's flying in from a round trip to Rome. And the two of them are flying down here at noon tomorrow. I don't think crazy.
I hope they meet the blizzard.
Well, Frank will be watching the weather. Listen, you better get
here.
People will be watching you fall on your face.
Right.
Come on. Say, Jim.
Okay. Yeah.
Jim? Did you see Louise Baker?
Oh, yes. Honey, it was too late. She got a family coming in from Indianapolis, and she couldn't stop them.
Well, when do you think these are going to arrive?
Sometime this afternoon, I guess. But don't worry, honey. I'm sure they'll telephone before they come out. It'll be all right. Okay.
Hey, don't sink mine.
Come in, girl. Get the sled. We're going to flush.
Margaret!
She's washing her hair.
Tell her I'm taking the kids sledding on Fox's Hill.
Okay.
What was that shouting all about?
Oh, Dad took the kids sledding.
Oh, good.
Way to help stop leaks. They're nearly 50% thinner than ordinary diapers for a trimmer, pant-like fit. And now reprogrammed with unique curved leg elastics, plus revolutionary materials absorb better than ever to help stop leaks. New Huggies Ultra Trim, totally redesigned to create big smiles.
Wear why? Sweatshirts, baseball caps, t-shirts. Fun gear for the cool kid in your unit. Wear Y and get noticed. Perfect for holiday gift giving. Order yours by calling this toll-free number today. 1-800-665-9881. Charge it to your Visa, MasterCard, or American Express. Money orders accepted, too. Wear Y and make a scene.
Introducing Pillsbury Pie Crust. Homemade flaky pie crust and nothing flat.
That's a great backyard. Perfect for a clubhouse for the kids and finally room for my ping pong table.
Well, we've never had room for that ping pong table.
Oh, come on.
Hello. Who are you?
Hello, I'm Louise Baker.
Hello.
This is Mr. and Mrs. Hendricks and their children from Indianapolis.
How do you do?
I'm a real estate broker. The Hendricks are here to look at the house.
Oh, I'm Jean Anderson. Is there anything I can do?
Well, we're waiting for Margaret. We seem to have caught everyone by surprise.
Oh, Louise, I apologize. I'm afraid you've caught us in a terrible mess.
I should have called first. I'm sorry we ran short of time. This is the Hendricks family.
How are you?
We had a minor flood in the kitchen. The kids were sailing in the boat and the lake ran over.
Sounds like home.
Well, Louise, why don't you show the Hendricks around? You know the house.
All right.
And just be careful in the kitchen because it's still kind of wet.
No problem.
We'll start in the dining room.
Get your coat,
Kim. Yes, come along. Let's look through here first, shall we?
Come on.
Okay.
I've been walking around. What a difference between this place and Minneapolis. I must have run into 10 people, I know.
What's out the window?
Nothing. I was just thinking about how your mother must feel. This house has meant a lot to her. I love it, too.
Come here. Oh, Bud, hello. I'm sorry to barge in on you like this. I'm the Hendricks family with me. This is Bud Anderson.
I do.
And the view over here, we can see the whole street from over here. Come. Isn't that pretty? You can see all the way down the block.
This is a darn time to sell the house.
Stop grousing.
If we'd known you were all coming, we could have waited.
We're not mind readers, you know. All right, come in.
Oh, yes, yeah, do. This was our girl's room.
You have a lovely home, Mrs. Anderson.
Just what we've been looking for.
Well, thank you. Just make yourselves at home. The colors in this room are lovely, aren't they? Really, sweetie, we have two closets for the clothing and bath on that side.
What, Cassie? Darling,
I'm sorry, Mom. Just seeing those people in our room and just all of a sudden hit me. This isn't going to be our home anymore.
Oh, darling, wherever the family is together, that's home.
Yeah, but it won't be like this. Oh, I'm sorry. I really am stupid.
Now, grown-ups cry, too. Come on, there. Oh, Cassie.
Well, Mr. and Mrs. Hendricks, have Louise shown you the whole house?
Yes, and we loved it.
Oh,
your
good.
House is just beautiful. Thank you for letting us see it.
Seems they have everything we've been looking for.
Mom.
Thanks very much.
Oh,
thanks for being there, kids.
Thank you.
Bye now.
Thank you again.
Come on.
Goodbye, Louise. I'm terribly afraid they're going to buy the house.
Yeah?
Come on, Grandpa! Let's put up the tree! Come on, Christmas Eve!
All right.
You're stronger than I am, Margaret.
Why do you say that?
Following your shoes, I'd be in tears.
Oh, nothing stays the same, Jean. Why fight it?
Hey, whoa, wait a minute.
Look at the rock and branches.
The rocks to hold up the tree, and the branches to make the living room smell good. Oh. Wait up, you guys!
Well, I never heard of a rock holding up a tree, but he's your son.
He's your grandson.
Oh.
That's dumb.
Oh, it is.
There we are.
Oh,
me. There's a picture we ought to have in the family album.
You know, I don't know why I'm doing all the heavy work today.
What heavy work? What are you doing?
Well, that's the last box in the garage.
Hey, Kathy, I think you should move the tree about a foot to the left.
You know, I don't think you broke your ankle at all.
You are a kid.
Bud, we need some more lights.
Well, we'll have to get them off the further house.
No. There's some up in the attic. In an old hat box.
Oh, you'll see.
In a hat box, sure.
Keep
it
in your Christmas stocking.
Fine.
I used to read stories about kids who played in the attic. I've never been up here before. Oh, this is terrific.
Oh. All the old family junk that nobody wants. Nobody wants to throw away.
Well, Bud, I know you say that I don't complain. I don't tell you what my needs are. Okay, I'm telling you, I want this. I want a home. I don't want it without you.
I know.
You're not around very much anymore. What are you looking for? A better woman?
Well, of course not. I love you. And I know I couldn't find a better woman. Oh, it's not you, it's me. I don't know, I can't settle down. You know, what I'm missing is this, all this right here. Home.
You really think it's taken us 12 years to find out we weren't the same thing?
Shame on us.
Dad, come on, we're waiting for the rest of the stuff.
Oh, we can't wait for it
all. You know what, Dad? This is the best Christmas we've ever had.
It's all right.
Don't shake the tree now, kid, because all those lights aren't put a hell on there too well.
Come on, we're going to do around the house this time of year.
Would you get that lamp, please? Now, hit the plug there.
Hello, Jim.
wasn't always like this. I remember the year it seemed a marvelous idea to go up in the woods and cut our own tree. And we were snowbound in an empty lodge with an old character named Nick.
Yeah, what's this? Tears on Christmas Eve?
Well, that's just it. It's Christmas Eve, but Danny won't ever find us up here.
Ah, that's how much you know about Sandy. I found out he knows exactly where you are.
How'd you find out?
Oh, that's secret stuff. But he'll be here. He might have a bit harder time finding the house among these big trees, but he'll find it. Come on, let's go and have some tea.
But even if he does find us, we won't have any Christmas tree for him, or any carrots for his reindeer.
Whoa, hold on. Do you know what's going to happen here tonight? A big, beautiful Christmas tree is going to grow up right through the floor. About right over there.
Well, there it is.
What do you think?
Sure, something.
It certainly is different, but it looks a little bare underneath. Kathy will love it. And she can get her presents when we get back home.
Presents?
Mother, those presents you put in the car to deliver? Mr. Kirkland will never miss it. Come on, Bud, get your coat on. We're going back to the car.
Well, follow me. Nick taught me how to walk into his father in the snow.
It does my heart good to see the kids being such good sports after the way I messed up their Christmas. I believe we have some pretty good kids there.
I'm sure of it.
He might have a bit harder time finding the house among these big trees, but he'll find it.
Quiet!
Pat?
Frank! That was Frank calling from Rome.
What's that?
He's not going to be here tomorrow night?
Oh, he'll be here with Betty.
Then why did he call?
He's bringing us a pizza and wants to know if we want everything on it.
No. Oh, I want to have the mushrooms.
Oh, yeah, so good. You
see it now.
Say it.
Seiko.
Seiko.
A spark.
Dad.
A flame.
To hold.
Seiko. Beauty in motion.
Advanced towards precision. A vision.
Seiko. The future of time.
At the Huggies Lab. What a breakthrough! Totally rethought, refined, redesigned new Huggies Ultra Trim diapers. A smart way to help stop leaks. They're nearly 50% thinner than ordinary diapers for a trimmer, pant-like fit. And now reprogrammed with unique curved leg elastics, plus revolutionary materials absorb better than ever to help stop leaks. New Huggies Ultra Trim. Totally redesigned to create big smiles.
Super duper busy.
If you see what your cinnamon toast crunch to the tin tastes,
I'll look inside.
The answer's in front of his face.
Cinnamon and sugar taste is swirled all over every bite.
What a totally intense taste any kid can see.
Cinnamon toast crunch is part of this complete breakfast.
So what do you think?
Super.
Hey, mind if I flap my gums? You know, some gums claim they won't cause cavities. But now Trident is the only gum proven to actually fight cavities.
It's true.
Because of an ingredient called Dentex.
Dentex.
Say it once to yourself. Only Trident's got it. Oh, and check this out. Only gum recognized by the Canadian Dental Association.
Oh, yeah.
Great tasting Trident with Dentex. Good for a smile.
Choo-choo.
Snow any more than this?
Oh, sure. By tonight, there probably will be more snow than you've ever seen in your entire life.
Nana?
Hmm?
We're going to go see the Christmas tree.
All right.
Oh, I'm sure that's for me. Hello? Uh-huh. Well, how'd they feel about it? Well, good. I'll be right down. Never thought I'd be doing business on Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
Whatever it is, smells great. Great, I'm going to be gone about an hour.
Well, Bud, while you're out, will you pick up some paper and ribbon?
Okay.
Something about that ring upset you?
Well, to tell you the honest truth, every time the telephone rings, I'm terrified it's going to be Louise saying the house has been sold. Ended early. There was no reason to wait for Frank. After that flight from Rome, he'd sleep all the way down here.
What?
If your summer fashions are any good, I might buy some from your wholesale retail.
Here's your friendly neighborhood mule.
Hey, thank you, Father.
Whoa, out here. What did you do, mug Santa Claus?
I picked up
a few things. Where are the girls?
Oh, the last I saw them, they were out in the backyard trying to decide where to build a snowman.
Oh, there they are. Oh, and you big girl. Just perfect.
Oh, Mommy, you know what? Christmas Eve. Isn't that neat?
Oh, that is neat.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here with that terrible weather they're forecasting.
Well, with Frank coming home safely, we'll batten down the hatches and let that storm blow.
He should just about be taking off from Chicago.
What am I going to drop?
Bobby!
Here's your Aunt Betty.
Hi.
Where'd my dad go?
Oh, you little charmer. He probably went Christmas shopping.
Oh,
well, where are
you? I'm sorry, Mother. But here it is.
Yeah, and I know it.
Hello?
Yes, she is. Just 1 minute, please. Mom, it's for you!
You girls, please stop yelling in the house. Hello?
Betty? I'm in Chicago. We have headwinds coming in, landed late. I missed my last plane south.
Oh, Frank, the girls will be so disappointed.
I'll get there, I guarantee it.
Frank, what kind of a plane? Well, you be careful. Bye-bye. Is anything wrong? He got in late, missed the plane down here, the only flight today.
Well, he can take the first flight out in the morning.
He insists he'll be here for Christmas Eve. He's borrowing a plane, flying it down himself.
Well, I'm sure he's watching the weather.
Mother, he insisted.
It's snowing more.
Captain Frank is fine in snow.
I know that.
What's that good, Nana?
Ah, pumpkin pies for tomorrow.
What is this?
It grinds up stuff.
Why do you plug it in?
You don't plug it in.
Don't take that apart, Robbie.
Oh. Frank came into my life the year I graduated from high school. He was a pilot in the Air Force, and we had a very short, very beautiful first romance. It was very real then, and so very real now.
I can never guess who that is up there. This isn't anything serious, is it?
I know it sounds silly. The giddy schoolgirl who meets the handsome flyer. But it's not that. This is real. For the first time in my life, I know what it means to love someone. For the first time, I understand how you feel toward Mother, and she feels toward you.
Waiting for a call. They're transferring some of the pilots, sending them to Alaska this morning. If he's going to stay, he's going to call at exactly 9 o'clock. If he's going to go, there'll be no call because he'll be flying over our house on his way north.
Talk to air traffic control. It's snowing all along the route from here to Chicago. Frank's flying alone in it somewhere.
Well, what time's he supposed to be here?
His flight plan said 5:20. 6 o'clock now. When did you last hear from him?
Over an hour ago. Said he was 8 miles northeast of Springfield and asked for landing instructions.
That's the last we heard of him. We lost radar contact a few minutes later.
Thank you. They've lost radar contact. No one knows where he is.
He can take care of himself, honey. Frank's blowing weather like this worse than this. Many, many times, believe me.
know what I can't figure out? With all his experience, why'd he even take off with a storm coming down on him?
He did it to please me. I made such a big deal. He had to be here for Christmas Eve. He did it for me.
Time you got to bed.
Oh, come on, Dad.
No, come on.
Good night, Ed. Kathy, good night, Nana.
Good night, Robbie.
Good night, Robbie.
Good night.
I'll check you in a minute.
Good night.
Good night, honey.
Good night.
I should have told him not to come.
Have you any idea how much fuel he had?
About 5 hours of flying. At 7:30, he burned the last of it. He's down somewhere around Clintville, as near as we can tell. If he doesn't call in, we'll start a search in the morning.
Thank you very much.
Airstream.
Oh, sure, he knows this route like the back of his hand. He could have landed at Clintville.
He would have called. Why don't we admit it? We all know what happened.
Maybe he's a long way from top. You don't know, Donnie. He might be on his way now. You don't know it. You can't...
Storm came in a lot faster than I expected. Caught me about 100 miles north. My visibility was dropping and the headwinds were eating up all the fuel. I knew I had to put down somewhere. I saw the lights of a farmyard away out in the distance, and I dropped down, circled around. I'll tell you, somebody up there must have been watching out for me, because it turns out that the farmer was an ex-pilot. I knew I was in trouble. He got his truck out, aimed the lights right down the pasture. I landed and drove me all the way back here. Hey, the phone was out. I did the best I could.
Captain Carlson, what's this?
Ooh, that's one of them. He must have taken one of his gifts by mistake. He had a whole truckload full of them.
Come in. Excuse me. I've lost one of my packages.
I took this by mistake. I'm sorry.
Thank you, son.
So I want to thank you again for everything you did for me.
It's all in the spirit of Christmas, son. Merry Christmas to all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
And to all a good night.
Good night.
Merry Christmas. Good night. Thank you.
That's weird.
What's his name?
You know, he didn't tell me. Quiet. I guess this is as good a time as any to tell you. The house has been sold.
This house for sale?
Yeah.
You never even told me.
Well, I didn't have a chance.
When did this happen?
Oh, a while ago.
Well,
Look, everybody, now, don't have such long faces. We'll have our reunions. We'll still get together.
But it won't be the same. It won't be here.
Well, I know, honey, but...
Listen, as long as we're making announcements, I'd like to make one. I've got some good news and some bad news. The bad news is that Robbie and Jean and I have to leave tomorrow for Minneapolis. The good news, as a Christmas present for Jean, I'm the one who bought the house.
Yeah.
It took me 12 years to figure out that, well, Springfield and a house like this is what we've been looking for, huh? Now, all I need from Mom and Dad is a small down payment and a lot of time on the balance.
You got it.
No, how happy I am.
Well, we couldn't have found it any better.
You know what? This is really super. Next year, we can all pile in on Bud and Jean.
Hey, that's a good idea, huh?
Oh, you tell us. Well, as soon as you and Jim decide what you want to do.
What a Christmas. I think we can all second that. What a Christmas.
Boy, you really get mixed up with these Andersons.
Yeah, you never know what they'll do next.
Oh, wait a minute. That's not fair at all, Paul.
All the years in this house. What a wonderful way to keep this family together.
Yeah. Do you think we should tell them the roof leaks?
Oh, sure.
It all started when a bunch of us at Zeller's got together to help fight cystic fibrosis.
It's a lung disease that was killing thousands of kids across Canada.
We were ready to walk to the moon if it would help.
So we called it Mahoa.
So far, we've raised millions of dollars. Why don't you join the Moonwalk team this Christmas?
When you shop at Zeller's, donate your Club Z points to Moonwalk.
Step by step, we can beat cystic fibrosis.
To the Zeller's employees, friends, and people across Canada who make Moonwalk a success, thank you and Merry Christmas.
Introducing Pillsbury Pie Crust. Homemade flaky pie crust and nothing flat. Fresh home-baked taste is as good as scratch. With new Pillsbury Pie Crust, you've got it made.
In the dairy case.
I like my Jillian to look dressed up, even when she's not dressed up.
Dr. Jennifer Mayer, pediatrician and mother.
But one thing I won't compromise on is dryness. That's why I like these new Pampers prints. They've got great looking patterns, and nothing keeps my Jillian drier here.
Compared to the next most popular diaper, Pampers for walkers help prevent leaks better.
When she's drier, she's happier.
Now all the dryness of Pampers also comes in the cutest new prints. For your little prince and princess.
They say you're gonna bloom. What are you, plant life? Please. You've got all these decisions. You've got a life. Hey, you can make it come up roses. It helps to use pH Balance Secret. Dryness protection when you want it most. See what happens when you protect one side with Secret when the pressure's on. Secret antiperspirant works harder to help keep you drier. So when you're faced with one of these, you won't pull one of these. Secret. Strong enough for him, but pH Balance just for you.
Here we go, come on.
I hope that furnace doesn't break down. That's ridiculous, goodbye, Robbie. Goodbye,
Robbie.
Goodbye,
Robbie.
Well,
come on,
you know. You guys, drive careful now.
You guys.
Well, hey, we're off.
Catch a glimpse of the North Pole and find out what's in the works when Santa calls on YTV. Catch him Friday at 6 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific. Check your local listings for exact times and ho, 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 you know.